Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to revisit an old clone effect I did way back, I do believe it was back in DaVinci Resolve 16. The first sheep that was cloned was called Dolly. And today, we're simply going to do a clone effect inside of DaVinci Resolve 16. And back then, I did, of course, this clone effect right here. And today we're going to revisit how to do that. And we're going to do it in a different way because DaVinci Resolve has become a way better editor than back then. It was great back then, but now it's really, really good. And we have some new tools we can actually use. And it will make this effect way easier than what I did back in the day. So without further ado, let's go right to that video inside of DaVinci Resolve 18.5. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and let's just quickly make this little clone effect. Some basic house rules for this effect, of course, is that to do this effect, you will need the studio version of DaVinci Resolve, because we are going to use one of the tools only available in the studio version. If you want to make this effect and don't have the studio version, you can still do it the way I did in the old tutorial. And of course, you can see that right up here in the top corner. So take a look at that. The technique will work still, so it's still good. One thing to note, if you're doing the effect this way, is that we do not need a clean plate at all. I know back in the day you would always do a clean plate, and I also did that for this video when I did that back in the day, but now we don't need to do that. So let's just jump right in. So the first thing we need to do is to take our top clip here. Actually, I'll just show you my clips. I have this clip here of me, and I'm just going to push D on the keyboard to deselect, and then I have this clip here over here of me again, and the last clip of me here. So again, I'm going to push D on both clips, so we have both clips. Then I'm going to take my top clip, which is my front clip. I'm going to push Alt, and I'm going to drag and doing a copy of that. And then I'm just going to push D on that, because we don't need it right now. So we're just going to start by selecting our video track 3. And then I'll go up to the inspector. And in the inspector, I'll go to the cropping, and I'm going to crop from left to right. Like that. And don't worry too much about this yet. Then I'll go to the second clip, which is actually this guy here. And I'll go into the cropping options for that clip. And I'm going to crop left until I can see my guy here. So something like that. Now both are in. And if we just play the clip right now, we can see that they're both moving, and everything is just the way we want it to be, except, of course, of the guy here that sucks big time. So how are we going to fix that? We are actually going to do that in the color page, but first we're going to select our clip, push D, and then we just need to do, and it's just to make things easier, actually. You don't have to do it this way, but I like to do it this way. I'm just going to give this a clip color, and just making it orange, jumping into the color page, selecting the orange clip here, and then I'm just going to go to the Magic Mask tool. And that is really a great, great tool in DaVinci Resolve now, and I'm going to use the object option, and I'm simply just going to draw on me, getting the different colors and everything. And I think that should be good. And then I can go here and see my overlay. If I toggle here, we can see my selection. And there is something I did not select, so I'm just going to add that in as well. Like that. And I might as well go to the quality and just push better, because it's going to be better. So let's see, there's some stuff here we didn't get, but if we want to remove stuff, we can just go on the minus and then just take a little of it off like that. I think that is good. And then we're just going to push this icon here, which means it's going to track forward and backward to make a decent track. And then we're just going to let DaVinci Resolve do its thing. Something like that. And, you know, it doesn't really matter if it doesn't track all the way super here. Actually, it doesn't really matter that much because we are going to fix that in 1 second after it's finished tracking. And it's not really a problem at all. So again, the Magic Mask is a great tool in DaVinci Resolve. It's really a tool you can have a lot of fun with and basically save your time by rotoscoping. So with the track done, I'm going to right-click over here at the grid and I'm going to add an alpha output. And I'm just going to connect this to the blue circle, making this a kind of an overlay, putting on top of everything. And if I go back to the color page here, I am just going to, you know, address this issue here. And I'll do that by selecting video track 3, going into the cropping, and then I'll just go to the lift. And, you know, I'm just going to put it back in. And then, you know, I'm just going to just give it a bit of softness to remove this line here, something like that. And basically, I think we should be all good here. We need to do a little bit of a change here as well, which will be on this clip here. So that just means I'll go to the right. And then, you know, I can just move that wherever I want that. And again, I can just soften things so we can move the line so it doesn't really see it. There we go. And there we are. Good. So that is the basic of how to do the clone effect. Of course, this is a bit boring because we are a static shot. If we want to bring a little bit of life into this, we'll go up to the effects, go into effects, and then we're just going to add in a adjustment clip. And I'm just going to make it fit the entire thing. And let's just search for an effect as well. Let's just write camera. And that is in the open effects. So we're going to take the camera shake tool and I'm going to put that in the adjustment clip. And if we just run the clip now without changing anything, this looks terrible. But if we select the adjustment clip, go over to the inspector and change the motion scale and also the speed scale. Quite a bit down, I think. Something like that. Then we have this very subtle, small movement, like somebody is actually hand-holding the shot. So that's how we could do this effect right now without using a clean plate or anything. Actually, we're not even masking stuff in this version, but if you don't have the studio version, of course, check out the old tutorial. It's still a great tutorial and it still works, so do that. But if you are in the studio version, this is the fastest way to actually do a clone effect super fast and super easy. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.